everyone, and welcome back to my channel. This is the fourth tutorial that I'm creating, and this time I would like to speak to those that work with packaging the mockups. I would like to create a realistic mockup that you can customize for your needs. My name is Daniele and I am a 3D artist. The first thing that we need to do is installing the keycast feature for Blender 2.8. I was asked by a user to show what I am gonna press on Blender, so basically this is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna put the link to the GitHub page in the comments of the video. To install the plugin, go to Edit, Preferences, and then simply press Install and select the addon where you downloaded it. You can select the zip file entirely, you don't need to unzip it. Once you have installed the addon, when you press N in the 3D viewer, you will be able to open a window, and on the bottom of that small window there is a label that allows you to customize your addon. You can change color, position, size, anything you need. To start with the project, we add a plane. I prepared a representation of a box completely unwrapped, a flat box, those that basically you need to fold to create the cubic box. I go on the top view and with the knife tool, pressing Ctrl key, I start subdividing in edit mode this plane. What you have to do is following the lines that you designed in your preferred software. I use Affinity Designer, you can do in Illustrator, even GIMP or Inkscape, there are many softwares. You can actually download it online, there are a lot of models that you can use. You simply cut the plane in all the positions where this plane is gonna be folded. The idea is to create a cubic box that's not just a cube, but that's a realistic box. And seeing that we start from the texture, you will be able to customize your box with any kind of texture. You will just have to replace the texture at the end, or just even use a plain color. You can use this for different reasons. If you work in mockups, for example, you can create a box that you can reuse and show your design on the box. If you need to design a box before it's gonna be printed, that's your deal. I recently worked on a website where I was asked to create visualization of the products before the product was actually created. And yeah, Blender can create very realistic artifacts, so why not? One of the things is that when you work on the edges of the small flat labels, I don't know how to call them, when you work on the edges, if you want to round them, all you have to do is adding a couple of additional loop cups. You will see on my video how I do. You don't really need to be precise. I mean, you don't really need to have a super round edge, because when you work in 3D, if something is gonna be seen from afar, you don't really need to be super precise. Another thing, when you add the loop cut and you want to move the vertices, you simply select the vertices in edit mode and you press G twice. The reason why you press G twice is that if you press it once and you press the axis where you want to move your vertex, you will be stretched the UV map, and this is not what you want to do. You want the vertex to slide across the UV map. If you press G twice, you don't really move the UV, so you don't stretch it. As you can see, the round edges are so small that you don't even notice that they are just two edges. In this case, edges is the 3D term for the small line that creates the polygons, the faces. This may be a little bit a long work. You need to do it for all the edges, but it doesn't take for a box like this more than, I don't know, 10 minutes. I usually speed up a little bit the videos, and as you can see, I am commenting the videos while I rewatch them. So that's one of the reasons why sometimes I end up keeping a sentence a little bit too long and not being able to finish it. Also, I'm registering with my computer, and this doesn't really help. Once you have done that, all you have to do is start folding the box as if it was a real box. You need to select all the vertices of the part of the box that you want to fold. I usually use C, so the selector. You can use if you press B, you have a box tool, a box selector, or C, you basically paint to select the edges. But the idea is to select last the vertex around which the whole box will rotate. So you select all the edges, and then the last edge needs to be the pivot point. If you go on the top and you change the selection mode, and you go into active elements, you will be able to rotate around the last element selected. And you can see that's the last element selected, because it will be white compared to the others that will be selected in orange. Again, you can change the way Blender shows those elements, so you can change the color of the elements. In any case, you need to rotate all the elements in a way that you fold the box. And my advice is always to over-rotate some of them in order to create those kind of overlapping pieces of paper that give realism to your object. Usually, even if the paper is really thin, it has some kind of solidify. Yeah, I mean, we're gonna add a solidify effect later, but this is the idea. Even if it's less than 1 millimeter, it has some kind of thickness. So what you have to do is consider consider the thickness of your object. Consider that some part will overlap, some part will be glued, and the glue also give a little bit of thickness to the object. You select in the end you select all the box, and you create basically a cube. Remember to keep the lid a little bit up, because no box closes hermetically. So in this way you can help to add realism. One of the things when you work with 3D is leaving a little bit of imperfection. This can be done in the texture, it can be done in the model. In the texture, usually the thing is any object has been touched by fingers and so on, so they leave some kind of imperfection. The other thing that you need to do is add modifiers. We try to work with modifiers because we want to work in a non-destructive way. In this example, I am working with a solidify modifier. Keep the thickness really small. And another thing, add three materials for the inner part, for the rim, and for the outer part. Other thing, when you import a plane in Blender, sometimes you may have the problem that it seems like the polygons are reversed. I don't know why this happens. The only thing to sort out this is recreate the material. It doesn't really change too much. Basically, you delete the first material and you add a new material. As you can see, I have my UV map. I open the UV editor and I have the UV map. And as you can see, the UV map of my object fits exactly the original map that I used to model it. This will help us in the second part of this tutorial, where I am gonna help you to texture what you created. What you have to do is add a bevel modifier. You can set up the bevel depending on the angle of the polygons, the faces, or you can also use a selection for the bevel. So you select the edges and you apply the bevel. In this case, I used angles. All you have to do is adding a bevel modifier at the end. The bevel will increase the polygons that are around edges of two faces. You can apply different methods. In this case, I applied angle. That means that whatever is over a certain angle will be modified. And last thing, if you want to keep sharp the edges, and last thing, if you want to keep the thickness of your paper sharp, you can also add an edge split modifier. The edge split modifier simply splits the edges of an object. You can add the edge split modifier after the solidify modifier. In this case, it's like you have two separate objects and the edge is not affected by the bevel modifier. I hope that you found this tutorial useful, and I would like to thank you, everyone that supported me. A lot of people supported me, I couldn't expect so much. And I really would like to thank you all, and I wait for you next week with the second part of this tutorial about texturing and rendering. See you next week.